So at this point in time, I'm assuming that most of you are really eager to learn what happened between Yusui Matsui and Tite Kubo for the Jump GIGA 2017 interview. And to say the least, there were no shocking announcements made during that interview, and I'm just gonna get straight into it for you guys right now, so please listen carefully. This is the summary of the 7 pages of the interview in GIGA magazine between Tite Kubo and Yusui Matsui. First of all, we would like to let you know that this is in no way a proper translation and that we do not intend on translating the whole interview. We skimmed through the 7 pages and got a general idea of the whole thing. We mostly focused on the answers Kubo gave and some bits and pieces of information that were considered either irrelevant or interesting. The following will be a summary of the content we found in it. We also acknowledge that our Japanese level is not that advanced, thus there may be some parts that lack accuracy or that we simply misunderstood. Take everything we write with a pinch of salt. If you happen to find mistakes, please let us know. So here we go, guys. This is the article I found off of Tumblr. It is 100% legit. So let's finish this interview once and for all. The mangakas had a talk and answered some questions that were previously gathered through an official Twitter account, questions related to creation in the interview we can find out from Kubo's roots to Matsui's younger years. Kubo says that what he wants to draw is what he can draw, and that if he ends up liking it, he will draw it. He also mentions that he had many ideas laying around for Bleach, and that he lost the memos somewhere. They had a long chat about some health issues and how Kubo would catch flus, him taking medicine and sleeping for a while, but as time passed, this wouldn't work anymore. Once the Bleach serialization was over, he had an MRI done due to an ache in his shoulder, and it showed that his tendon was broken. The next question about the mangaka that inspired them, Kubo said that for him, it was Mizuki Shigeru, the creator of Gigigi no Gitaro, that he would imitate this style. Those are his roots. Matsui then mentions that Kubo has outgrown these sketches and that he has found his own style. They also talk about Kubo's interest in ghosts, shinigamis, and the things that one may not notice, but are there. Someone asked them something along the lines of, what is the most important thing when presenting the characters to readers? Make them likable. He basically said that he hasn't really thought about it, so he doesn't really know. The next question, how do you create and draw characters' layouts and camera works? Kubo replies that he doesn't think about it, he does it out of intuition. He has a mental image of the whole thing, and he takes it from there. Not really sure about this one. They mentioned something about movies, and apparently Kubo found the movie 300 very inspiring for camera works and so on. Matsui compliments him on many of these things, blah blah blah. The translators were a bit confused with this next part, but let's get into it. The planning of the setting and the story seem never ending. Until what point should one write the story and start drawing? Kubo then says, at the point where you think that the character is fine and you can discover a lot of things. The next question is this, from the works of the both of you, what surprised you? Matsui says that the lost agent with Ginjo and Tsukishima really drew his attention, especially the part where Ichigo was crying. He even thought that Ichigo wouldn't be able to stand, blah blah blah. Then Kubo comments that when drawing Bleach, he felt like drawing something else. But when he finished, he thought that since he was tired, it was okay, like whatever was fine. Not so sure about that, but whatever. The next question was this, in your life as a mangaka, what has been your happiest moment? Kubo then replies, when I was in Germany and a seminude, a beautiful woman hugged me, a cosplayer, and then he laughed. Then both mangakas get serious and say that this is one of the most difficult questions. Matsui mentions that the fact that you can connect with others is interesting, to which Kubo adds, then you can meet different people in this world, and that as your work expands, your world does as well. This is the final and most important question for both Kubo and Matsui. Have you ever thought about drawing a new manga? None of them has thought about it. That's right, guys. None of them have ever thought about doing a new manga. However, Kubo comments that when he finished Bleach, he thought about drawing something about figure skating. And that's because there was an anime of it, Yuri on Ice. And he doesn't feel ready to start something new yet. He can't draw things that he doesn't like after all. He also points out that even if you draw for people, it won't become one satisfaction. The main reason to become a mangaka is that even when alone, you can do as you please. Both of them mentioned that now that their mangas are over, they have plenty of time. Kubo spends his time playing Zelda, and Matsui got a new tablet and he is practicing CG. He mentions that he is getting used to it, he can't draw manga yet though. Now, with all of that being said, in a nutshell, it ends with both of them saying that none of them has thought about doing a new project at this time, and that is the end of the interview for Jump GIGA 2017 between Tite Kubo and Yusui Matsui, the creators of Bleach and Assassination Classroom. Now listen and listen well, guys, before you leave this video. I am not done supporting Bleach, and I will not stop for a very long time until the anime is brought back to us. I will blissfully admit to you guys that the trail has gone cold a bit again, but that's not going to stop me from supporting it for you guys very strongly. Bleach needs to come back. It needs to return as an anime. The Thousand Year Blood War arc must be animated with a brand new alternate ending to make sure that fans are satisfied with whatever they come up with at the studio if they decide to animate the final part. Masashi Kudo has stated that they can do things later. It really doesn't matter if people say the Bleach anime is dead. There is still hope. Continue to support it strongly, because if you give up, that's it. That's the end. We still have a lot more going for us. Bleach is not dead. We still have the light novels, which are selling really well. We have the Bleach live action movie coming next year, so please support that. We have Bleach Blu-ray merchandise. Please buy that and support Bleach. Show your support. We have streaming services. Please visit the official streaming services to support Bleach. I'm talking about Hulu, Crunchyroll, Netflix, all the official streaming services. Please go down, support Bleach. Watch Bleach off of each of them. And please show your support with all of your might, because I can feel it. One day Bleach will return to us, and that's when fans will rejoice. It will be a happy day. I can feel it. I know it will happen at some point, guys. All we have to do is show our support to the bitter end, and that's when Bleach will come back to us as a whole for the Thousand Year Blood War arc. I am recalling a very good anime quote, and I can't remember which anime this is from, but if you lose something, you'll find it again, no problem. But if you throw it away, you will never see it again. And that is basically what I'm trying to tell you guys. If you throw it all away, we're just gonna have to forget about Bleach getting animated altogether. Countless animes have been brought back from the dead. Bleach is definitely no different. I say this in every single video. Please do not leave here today saying Bleach is dead. Bleach is still alive in some ways, more or less. And as we, the Bleach community, continue to make a stand and show our support strongly for what we think is right, there is no end to what we can accomplish. A lot more can be done for Bleach if we continue to show our support. I have a great feeling that there will be more opportunities like this interview in the future, so please do not hesitate, go down to my channel, hit subscribe, and also subscribe to James Hansen for more Bleach news in the future, and I will see you guys, as always, in the next Bleach video. Thank you for watching, and have a great day.
Okay, okay. Outside the scapegoat, you're a rootin' boy.
excited right now.